There are so many things that we love to celebrate around here, and there's one that is actually very, very special. We're talking about National Police Week being observed this week through Saturday. Every week should be National Police Week for all the great work that law enforcement does. And speaking of great work that's being done, how about we say good morning to Sergeant Paul Parizic from the Des Moines Police Department this morning. Good morning, Paulie. How are you?
Hey, Joe, how are you guys doing?
So it is a National Police Week celebrating the great work that law enforcement is doing on a daily basis. Thank you so much, first and foremost.
Well, thanks everybody for the support.
No, and speaking of support, people have been celebrating National Police Week around here. And tell us about some of the different ways that you've observed people celebrating.
Well, you know, we've had a lot of folks come in and make some donations to the police department. They know that things are different for everybody else. So a lot of giving and receiving and sharing and caring going on. So we've had very generous donation from Blake Newton over at Country Financial. He made a cash donation directly to the Guardian Project, which will help us not just now, but well into the future. Some of the immediate things, we've had folks donate a ton of food, Baratas, Big Al's Barbecue. Those are just a couple off the top of my head. And Target donated some disinfecting wipes, help us keep things clean and keep our crew healthy. So great things like that are going on. So we certainly appreciate it.
So now, if people are driving around and they're seeing flags at half staff, is that in honor of what we're keeping an eye on this week?
Yeah, so back in 1962, President Kennedy actually made the proclamation that May 15th is Peace Officer Memorial Day. So, and the week around that being National Memorial Week. So the governor made the order late last week that we put our flags down half staff just to honor the officers that have been killed in line of duty.
Now, a question for you too is, with what is going on right now, it has to be so difficult for all your officers to be able to carry out their day-to-day duties. How have things changed in the past couple of months since everything came into play?
Well, you know, I think, you know, the same thing that everybody else has, you know, just a lot of hypervigilance about being clean and doing our best to keep our crew safe. And the one thing that hasn't changed is we can't socially distance ourselves from people. It's just not possible for us to do that and deliver the service that we, our community certainly expects and deserves. So a lot of that back office type of thing, just constant cleaning, and then the adjustments that we've had to make in our personal lives. But it's impacted Police Week significantly. We've had to, not just locally, but nationally, they cancel all the Police Week celebrations, which usually draw about close to 50,000 people to Washington, D.C. this week. We had to cancel our run, our Police Week activities at the police station, which, you know, are a really great opportunity for us to connect with the community on, you know, at an informal basis, more of a friendly time. So we're missing those activities. We're missing those connections, but we're trying to backfill it and do what we can to stay in people's lives. You mentioned a photograph of one of the birthday parties. We've had a lot of kids around the community invite us to their birthday parties, which has been absolutely amazing.
So, yeah, you guys, yeah, there's one there. You want to wish them a happy birthday here today. But you mentioned that you guys will do drive-bys wishing people a happy birthday?
Yeah, you know, they've been sending emails to me or maybe messaging us on Facebook. And we'll go by and, you know, share some time with the kids. It's just as good for us as it is for them. I mean, some of those, well, you and I were together last weekend down at the Kiwanis Parade of Players for the Miracle League. That's one of our favorite events every single year. And we probably get more out of it than everybody else does because it's just such a heartwarming event. So things like that, we're just trying to replicate them the best we can and still get through this thing so we all come out on the other side healthy and happy.
Yeah, to be honest with you, Paulie, I'm really amazing. You are popping up everywhere. You mentioned the Kiwanis Miracle League last week. You were there and with another one of your officers. So you really are involved in so many different levels in this city, and that's really important to you, isn't it?
Yeah, you know, I like, you know, I love this city. I love the people here. One of Chief Winger's mandates when he took over was that he wanted the people in this town to know their cops by first name. So I don't really have a neighborhood that I police anymore. So I try and jump in there wherever I can just to do my part and make sure I represent the folks that are out there grinding every day to keep this town safe.
Okay, I want to talk a little bit about the officers that are on the street, the ones that are in the patrol cars. Are there any special mandates that you have for those officers? Because we've seen around the city of Des Moines and some other cities around Des Moines, they're wearing the face masks and they're wearing gloves and things like that. Are you guys implementing those similar type of steps?
Yeah, so we've got what we call the COVID-19 officer response continuum, and it it guides our officers from a potential exposure to a known exposure. So we're following all the CDC guidelines and the Iowa Department of Public Health. As far as face masks go, we all of our officers have the PPE that they need. But in your day-to-day duties, we're leaving that kind of discretionary right now because there are a lot of folks in our community that don't respond real well to a masked police officer. And that's something that we had to take into consideration, for some people that could be a little spooky. So we're doing our best we can to keep our distance. But, you know, those cops on the street, that's the backbone of our organization day in and day out. And they are doing a fantastic job. I'm lucky because I get to talk about their work, you know, but they're the ones who are out there putting in the blood, sweat, and tears to make things happen.
Yeah, but you were on the street at one time too, Paul. We remember that. So you know what it's like. So you can relate to what they are going through. And we salute each and every one of them because they have the courage to go out there each and every day. And, you know, it's one thing to go out there and realize what the dangers are. But now when you have this other danger in the way of COVID-19, that just stacks on top of everything that they are doing. So we thank them, big time. Thank you so much.
Yeah, you're welcome. You know, we got a class graduating Friday, too. So there's going to be some new fresh faces out there.
Really?
Yep.
That is awesome. Now, is there anything else? Again, one more time, we are celebrating National Police Week. Want to make sure that we're very aware of this. And he mentioned what's happening on Friday, the 15th, a day of recognition. Anything that people can do to show their gratitude for what the law enforcement officers are doing?
You know, the one thing that always kind of hits us in the heart is just a simple thank you. Pop into our social media. We're going to be dropping some videos that honor the officers because we can't gather and have those memorials. So I have the State Patrol, our organization, and a lot of other metro agencies put together something just to kind of honor the memory and honor the service. So a big thank you is all we ever ask for.
Yeah, never forget. Thank you so much. Sergeant Paul Parizek, Des Moines Police Department. You take care of yourself, buddy. You stay healthy and keep doing the incredible work.
Thanks a lot. See you guys later.
There you go. That is our good friend, Sergeant Paul Parizek from the Des Moines Police Department. Stay home, stay healthy. Reminder from the Des Moines Police Department, Police Week, National Police Week. Make sure you say thank you to a police officer. As Paul says, jump on social media. If you see them, give them a salute and give them a thank you. We